Hello guys, welcome to the second video. How to save reminders on your Google Calendar. You first need to log into your email and then you click here on these 9 points in the right upper corner. And then you look for this icon that may be around, somewhere around here, which is called Calendar. I suggest you put it here. On Google Calendar, you can create events for Google Meets, video conference, and stuff like that. Or you can just create events only for the sake of setting reminders. Well, I use it like that. I also use the calendar on my phone. This is a very easy way to remember. Since you have your email open, then there's no problem. If you know other way to create reminders, you can leave your strategy right down on the comment section. Okay, so I'm actually going to schedule a reminder for an actual assignment that you guys have for English. So for example, this one is due to the 21st of August. So I need to organize that reminder on my calendar so I don't forget and I hand in the homework on time. So to do that, I need to organize the calendar. Oh, this is something that I forgot to mention at the beginning. The calendar could be organized by day, week, or month. My recommendation is that you organize it by month. So you can see all the days within the month. You see all the days within the month. And here on the left upper corner, you can, you know, move from month to month. So this reminder needs to be set on the 21st of August. So I go to the month, which is August, and then I go to the day.
In this part, you are seeing that there are several options: event, out of office, reminder, task, appointment slots. But on this video, I'm going to show you only the event, because to me is the one that offers more options for you to set several reminders, and it's very easy to edit and everything. If you want, you can check the others out and see if they work better for you.
Then I click more options over here. And I'm going to write down here, entregar tarea de inglés. Okay, and 21st August. Here is the interesting thing. If you want to create an event, a video conference meeting and everything, you click here, and on this part, you write down the emails of the people who you want to invite. But in this case, I'm not going to do it because it's for me, it's for myself, it's just a reminder. It's because I want my cell phone to ring or show me a message telling me that I need to hand in this assignment on that particular day. So I just write down here,
el 21 de agosto, debo entregar, el 21 de agosto es la fecha límite para entregar el trabajo de inglés.
If you want, you can also write down what is that particular activity. In this case is Duolingo and Be the One challenge. So you copy this and you put it here. You can put it in brackets, between brackets, Be the One challenge and Duolingo. And there you go. Please make sure you unmark this, okay? Let's put it at 8 in the morning. And then add notification 10 minutes before. I'm just gonna write down 1 hour before. And here notification 1 day before. Another notification 2 days before. So you make sure 2 days before. Another notification, let's say 3 days before. And the last notification 1 week, 1 week before. You can set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 5 notifications. And you can even choose the color of that notification, so you will see on your phone that color in the message or on your calendar also. So this is a way to differentiate the events that you have on the calendar. So let's say that for English, you always will use, let's say, tangerine, this color. And then you click here, save, you know? And now on the 21st of August, you have this event. Okay, and you have 5 notifications, 1 notification 1 hour before 8, it means at 7 on the 21st. You have another notification 1 day before, so on the 20th at 8 o'clock exactly, you will receive a notification on your phone reminding you about it. Another thing you need to have in mind is that you can set this notification to your email. So if you want to receive an email from Google reminding you that you have to entregar this tarea, then you choose one notification 2 days before or 3 days before by email. The other notifications are going to be received on your phone, but this particular one is going to be received on your email. So if you have your email open on your phone, you will also receive that notification on your phone. This is a very useful strategy not to forget, let's say, the tasks that I have, the assignments that I have. If you have any questions, you can leave them right down on the comment section. Please start setting up your calendar so you don't forget to hand in your homeworks. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.